Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, we'll learn how to configure Google Merchant Center shipping attributes in our product feed. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. Right now in our site, let's go ahead and create a new feed and test out the shipping attribute. Let's click on New Feed. United States, fine. Template, let's use Google Shopping. Let's give this a name. Shipping to. XML is fine. Everything else looks good. Let's give it a category. Apparel accessories. And now here we add the new attribute. The attribute that you're looking out for is shipping. There we go. And I'll add it right here as well. There we go. Shipping Google format. So I'll choose that. Let's update and generate our feed. Let's take a look at what the feed looks like. Let's take a look at our feed. Right now in our feed, we can see that the shipping attribute is coming through, but there's no information under it. That's because in our site, we haven't configured the shipping information yet. So let's go ahead and do that right now. To add the shipping information, go to WooCommerce, click on Settings. Under Settings, you'll see the Shipping tab. As you can see right now, we don't have any shipping zones configured. So let's go ahead and do that right now. Now let's go ahead and add a few shipping zones. Let's say the first one is USA, region, United States. That's what I'm looking for. And let's say we're going for a flat rate. Let's add it. And when you edit it, you can put the costs under it. So let's say I'm gonna charge them $10 for shipping around USA. That's done. Let's create one more. Add shipping zone. Let's say USA, California. There we go. Let's say for California, we're going to give them free shipping in California. So let's go ahead and add that. Boom, done. Let's add one more. Let's say USA, New York. There we go. Let's say for New York, we're gonna use local pickup. So let's choose that, add shipping method, and we are all done. Last but not the least, let's add one last one. This time, let's go for a remote place. Let's say Australia. Ooh, Australia, there we go. And let's say we're going to give them a flat rate, but since it's a bit further away, I want it to be a bit more expensive. So I'll charge them $20. Let's save changes. Now that we have configured all these new shipping zones, let's go back to our feed and check if they're coming through. Let's go back to CTX feed. Let's regenerate it. Time to have a look right now. Now, if we scroll down in our feed, let's take a look at the shipping information. As you can see, you've got US coming through, which is flat rate. That's $10 plus GST, making it $11. And next, we've got the one for California. As you can see, it's free shipping, so it's $0. However, right now, we can't see the other two. Let's take a look why they're not coming through. We can see here, New York is set to local pickup. Since it's local pickup and there is no need for shipping, it's not going to show up under the shipping attribute. Now there is a reason Australia is not showing up. Let me show you how you can fix this issue. To do that, go down to CTX feed and go to settings. Scroll all the way down and here you'll see add shipping cost for all countries to feed. Since this option was disabled and under our feed, if we take a look at it, the country is set to United States. That's why Australia's shipping was not being picked up. Now let's go back to our settings and enable this option so that we can see the shipping information for Australia. Let's go save changes. Let's go back to our feed and refresh it. Let's take a look at it now. Let's take a look at our feed now. There you go, guys. As expected, now you can see the shipping information for Australia. There you go, guys. Now you know how to configure Google Merchant Center shipping attributes in your feed. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.